Hi guys, welcome to the Saving Money Show with me, your host Sean. I wasn't planning on making this video, however, after speaking to my man Rex and a couple of other YouTubers, I felt I had to before the markets opened. I made my JNSH video after the market closed, and so hopefully none of you have purchased it. Everything I said rang true. It is classing itself as a supplier to Blink. It is also supposed to be a supplier to ChargePoint, which makes me wonder why it's so down. As I said, it's probably a middleman more than making the charges itself, which could be why it's down there, because the commission it's making isn't so much. However, the red flag I was worried about was the fact that you couldn't call up and speak to anyone. You couldn't contact anyone. Now, I will be pulling my investment, purely because I'm worried that it may be a defunct company, or soon to be a defunct company. There are just too many red flags cropping up the more I look into it. And there are other people who I've spoke to, who I respect, who have looked into it, who are saying the same. I'm sorry if it comes across that I've misled you. This happens sometimes when you're looking for early stage companies. However, and when you're looking for information and get it out before other people. However, I do try to confirm my information beforehand, and I did think it came from a good source. Now, I will try and be a bit more vigilant in the future, and we're going to move on to the next thing. I've been asked about Dropbox. I have said, if you remember my previous videos, when it was $18 a share, when it was $20 a share, I said anything under $25 if you're holding long term is a good entry point. Anything under $20, you should scoop it up. Anything under $19 or $18 is a steal. I made an entry point at $22, and everything under $22, and you know for a long while it's been under $22, $20, $19, $18, I scooped it up. Now, although it says $22.50, it's sitting at $24.50 after hours. The reason for that, as I said before, there were rumours of a takeover. Now, the thing is, people who are looking to take over, and I'm not going to talk about Apple, because it was recommended that Apple take them over at the beginning of the year, but there's been no talk about Apple taking them over. It's apparently it's Salesforce and ServiceNow. Well, ServiceNow have 10 times the valuation of Dropbox, so that would make sense. Salesforce, well, it would make sense because their market cap and the amount of money they have would make sense for them to make the acquisitions, rather than, like with Slack and so on, rather than pay tax. And if they're worried that Biden's going to come in with this tax thing, then it would be cheaper for them to build a moat, which is what they're trying to do, in my opinion. And apparently one or two other companies are interested as well, but I can't confirm who. And all you need is two companies interested, and you could have a bidding war. As I said, at $25, long term, it's worth having. Why has it been down so much? Because Wall Street doesn't like the fact that their market share has dropped from 34% to 30% to 24% to 20%. Wall Street doesn't like that. But you have to realise, still have 20% of the cloud storage market, a market which is due to grow. And of course their market share of that is going to drop because more companies are entering it. And what they're not realising is, huge winner for them is their e-sign business. And this is why, one of the reasons I went in there. You have DocuSign, which is unprofitable at the moment, went and has soared. And I sold my DocuSign to pick up Dropbox, and I've done a video on that previously. And the Dropbox is the number two e-sign business. Why would I have done that? Well, mainly because I think it's undervalued. Secondly, I was getting DocuSign documents every week, and then all of a sudden they changed to Dropbox e-sign documents. Now, I've said before how with Zoom, and I do think Zoom has lots of rooms to grow. Yeah, but there are companies who, if they are, especially the bigger companies, if they're with one company, say for instance, company I work for is with Microsoft for the Office and Excel and all that. Rather than bringing Zoom, they have our Salesforce, so they have Microsoft Teams, and they bring in Microsoft's programs. It'd be the same with this, with Dropbox. They would have Dropbox eSign. Now, things like DocuSign and Zoom will always be the number one to go to, but some companies will always look at the price of these things. Ah. Hi guys, welcome to 7 Money Show, with me, your host Sean. Well, for those of you in the workhorse, if you head over to my YouTube channel, you will see how I've spoke about Romeo Power Batteries have confirmed an order of $2.4 billion on batteries. I apologise for background noise, I'm not in my usual setting. And TPI Composites have announced the order for more vehicles. They've both said they cannot speak more about it, which screams an NDA. And on top of that, a congressman has spoken about bringing $800 million or more jobs to Lordstown Motors with the USPS contract. All the information is in my channel. Looking at a company I spoke about before, Morrisons, goes ex-dividend soon, as special dividend as well. Now, I said before how with Brexit, is well suited because it's transferred from a lot of foreign goods to a lot of UK goods. It still has some foreign produce, of course, but with a no deal Brexit, that will help it out. It also partnered with Amazon Whole Foods to pack up and deliver Amazon Whole Foods. And it's one of the two supermarkets which are going to repay COVID business rates, and people are going to see that as a good thing, and I think people will decide on that. Now, this is regarding IDEX. Thought you might want a quick look at that. people have been asking me, should I sell or should I keep in? Only you can decide that. Depends how much profit you've made on that. Now, personally, I think if you've made your profit, then you should consider getting out. Now, if you haven't, then fine, stay in. But a lot of people going about Kimberly Clark and how secure it is, and to tell the truth, you're getting it at the price you would have had pre-Rona. So it's not a bad price to get it at. I like the fact that as well that you get in. If you look at last year's, it's improved its debt to assets. Last year, its debt to assets was 99%. Now it has 600 million more in assets than it has liabilities, which isn't a lot for a company this size, but it is still good. But a company I like, it might be because I'm in the UK, so I don't have to pay with holding tax on it, you know. But Unilever, and again, you're getting it at a discount, and you will see that again, you're getting it pre-Rona prices, and that was just before pre-Rona, or you're getting it from the price it was in June. Whatever way you want to look at it, is 3.39% dividend, 17.49 PE, and it's, I think it's a 13 forward PE. Now, if we look at the financials, and thing is, both Kimberly Clark and Unilever have low payout ratios, under 50-60%. Now, it's basically a third. A preferred is to Kimberly Clark, because Kimberly Clark is in the 95-99% debt to equity. With this, it's 33% debt to equity. I just, I said 33%, it's about 36%. And I find it a much better one. You have a lot more wiggle room. They can take on more debt at a low rate if they need to. And I do think it's one to be looking at. Now, again, I'm sorry if anyone felt I was misled by my JSNH video. It wasn't my intention. Please hit the like button and comment in the box below to get this out to as many people as possible, so anyone who watched my original video will not be misled. That is the main intention of this video. I'll see you in the next one.